Hello and welcome to the installation and image acquisition on Ruler3000 and SIM2x00 video in the SIGNUVA series. In this tutorial, I will show you how to acquire high-quality 3D images of smaller and fast-moving parts using Ruler3000 and SIGNUVA. For a general introduction to SIGNUVA 3D, I recommend to watch the Discover SIGNUVA in 3 Dimensions video before continuing. Let me start by quickly walking you through my test setup. The Ruler3000 offers several product variants that differ in distance, field of view and precision. Just select the variant that fits your application best. For my application, I need to measure milkshake packages in 25 cm distance, so I use the Ruler3000 20 variant. I've mounted the device parallel to the conveyor belt with a distance of 38 cm. Its laser line must be perpendicular to the direction of movement. This device utilizes a laser, so for safety reasons, please ensure not to look directly into it. The Ruler3000 sends a laser line into its field of view and uses the reflected light to capture a height profile of the object, exactly where the laser line of the sensor is visible. To capture a full 3D image of the object, it has to move past the sensor, and many of these profiles need to be recorded. The sensor integration machine SIM2x00 edge computing device captures these single profiles and assembles them into a full 3D profile. The 3D image can then be easily evaluated using the image analysis tools of the SIGNUVA sensor app running on the SIM2x00. The Ruler3000 is connected to the following ports of the SIM2x00. The S1 sensor connector to get power. The Ethernet port 2 to transmit the single profiles. And the ink port through a splitter to get position information. For highest data quality, the spacing between the single profiles needs to be equal. An encoder connected to the splitter at the ink port of SIM2x00 provides this information independent of conveyor speed or acceleration. In addition, I mounted a trigger sensor and connected it to the S2 sensor connector. As everything is mounted and the SIM2x00 is powered up, let's start with the configuration. Therefore, my laptop is connected to the Ethernet port 1 of the SIM2x00. To access the user interface, open a web browser like Google Chrome and enter the default IP address of the Ethernet 1 connection, 192.168.0.1. In SIGNUVA, you can store configurations for multiple applications called jobs. Each job is based on job templates. For common applications, we offer predefined job templates where the recommended tools are already configured. Let's start solving this application from scratch. So I select the empty job template and confirm with Create. Let's power the Ruler3000, the encoder, and the trigger sensor directly from the SIM2x00. To do so, select System on the top left, click Power Configuration, and enable the power output of Ink1, S1, and S2. Now let's wait around 25 seconds until all devices are booted up. To establish the communication between the Ruler3000 and the SIM2x00, select Sensor Connection on the left and click the Select Sensor button to search for the Ruler3000. As the IP settings do not match, select Fix IP to automatically solve this issue. Choose the sensor and confirm with Select. Now it's time to configure the acquisition settings. Switch back to the Jobs page and select the Laser Detection Setup button on the right. Place a sample centered below the laser line and make sure that the most important object features are illuminated. In my case, the cap of the milkshake package with its QR code. In the Laser Detection Setup window, reduce the tool region to include the relevant areas. In my case, the top contour of the milkshake package, and leave some margin on both sides to account for some position variation. Select the Auto Setup button to automatically set the exposure time and laser threshold. As I can see some missing data where the QR code is printed in black on the cap, I increase the exposure time to 25 microseconds. Close the window with OK. Next, I configure the encoder. Find the Profile Trigger section and change the mode to Encoder. As I don't know the resolution of my encoder, let's use the Calculate Resolution tool. Simply move an object a known distance and calculate the encoder resolution based on actual encoder values. First, mark a fixed reference position near the conveyor and place a matching mark on the conveyor. I use sticky notes with little arrows for that. In SIGNUVA, select the Calculate Resolution button to open the corresponding window. Click Mark Start to save the current encoder value. Then, let the conveyor move for some distance and stop it again. Back in Nova, click Mark End. Use a measuring tape to measure the move distance, in my case from the reference position to the mark on the conveyor, and enter this value as distance from start to end. The encoder resolution is calculated automatically, in my case around 33 pulses per millimeter. Confirm with OK. Depending on your application setup, select the fitting encoder mode. For me, direction down is correct. As my milkshake packages are moving along the conveyor belt, I installed a trigger sensor to always capture the 3D images at the same position. To activate the trigger signal in Signova, find and expand the image trigger section on the right, change the external trigger setting to input, and the input source to S2 pin 4 for sensor 2 pin 4 of the SIM2000. Last, we need to define the length of the 3D image in the direction of movement. Scroll down to the 3D image section on the right and adjust the image length value to the length of your sample with some margin. For my milkshake package, the default value of 100 mm is perfect. Switch to run as configured below the live image. Now the camera only captures images when the trigger sensor has detected a package. Let's capture the 3D profile of a milkshake package. Once the package passed the sensor entirely, it is displayed in the live view. Switch to the 3D view and change the visualization to hybrid to overlay height and intensity data. To further enhance the view of my object, I activate the lighting option and select automatic range in the color tab. To enhance certain details on your parts, just test different visualization options. Let's test our configuration. Run some packages past the Ruler3000 and check the results. Great, all packages are captured correctly. I now click the Save Permanent button in the top right corner to save my configuration to the SIM2000. Amazing! Who would have thought 3D image acquisitions of smaller or fast-moving objects could be this easy? Now that everything is set up, we are ready to solve even challenging 3D quality inspections using Ruler3000 and SIM2000 with Signova in the next video. Stay tuned!